One week and one day in to the Dapper Vogue official 2020 launch, and I'm here to share with you some of my thoughts on how it's going so far. I want to bring up first the lag fixes and the bug fixes that have been implemented already. It's astounding to see that the staff have already gotten so on top of things that the issues that were brought up within the first 24 hours that I mentioned have almost all already been fixed. And although we did have further problems with lag, for example, just as the weekend was coming up, the last weekend, the lag became a little bit more intense again, but they couldn't fix it because the coder was away for the weekend, which is completely reasonable. That's slowly being fixed as well, I think. Please don't quote me on that. However, the site is running smoother for me personally, so I believe the lag is being fixed. There were also adventuring fixes. The adventuring was getting a little bit chaotic there. There were a few issues with it crashing and freezing, with error codes coming up. That seems to have been majority fixed now. There are also new non-gacha clothing that have been implemented just for the official launch in general. It hasn't been done over the last week, but over the last week I've obtained access to Peddler's Port, and I'm here to say that Peddler's Port is filled with some really cool clothing items. There are all of the clothing items that you would have been able to choose when you first came into the world of the Dapper Vogue, the class-specific ones, and a bunch of other clothing items that would be considered more regular for our real society, like tank tops and mini skirts and tights, rather than a long billowing wizard cloak and a couple daggers. Unless you consider daggers and wizard cloaks to be normal attire, then this is just even more regular. Unfortunately, all of the items that are at Peddler's Port sell out rather quickly, but this is because it doesn't operate on the same gacha system that all of the other towns' machines will operate on. So, say in Lilia's shop, you would spin for approximately 6,000 or 7,000 potatoes, and you would receive 10 random items. In the Peddler's Port shops, you would go through and all of the items available are in a random stocking method, more like what Neopets would have or what Novella would have. And you would select one and pay a specific amount of potatoes and obtain that specific item. So Peddler's Port works very, very differently from the rest of the site. It's almost like the connection between Dapper Vogue and the real world. There are also new clothing items in every single one of the gachas that I've encountered thus far. When I first played in the first 24 hours, I wasn't doing that much gacha spinning. I was saving all of my potatoes so that I could do some mass Barclay spins. I think I did about 150 Barclay spins in total. Anyways, the point is, I didn't see a lot of the clothing items that were around, except in trade lots, and then I just kind of thought they were throwaway items or came from referrals. But actually, it seems that every single gachapon in Louise Hill and Three's Forest has an extra accessory item. Bully, it's these, like, essence bands. For the wizard, it's a dangling keychain. For Barclay, it's a little plush pet that floats in the air. The forums have still been incredibly active through the entire week. So whenever I refresh the forum page, whether it be in the span of a second or 5 minutes, all of the topics will change. And the topics in each section are constantly changing. People are talking a lot, and it's really great to see so much activity in the site, even after a week has progressed. Hopefully that continues on through the next month, through the next year, but we'll see how things go. Obviously, if something major happens and people start disappearing, things might slow down. But until then, things are seeming super active, and if you want to get in on the fun and the forums, there's a bunch of hangout threads, there are so many forum games, or you can just introduce people into the world every few seconds. Something entirely new that's happening in the 2020 launch is, like I mentioned in the other videos, the random events that are popping up. These initially were just seeming to offer potatoes and recipes, but now they also offer snails. Snails are one of the important ingredients for the June event, June Rainbows. It's a pride-focused event and everything is rainbow-coloured, and you used to be only able to obtain these by alchemizing 5 random items and hoping for the best, but now your pet can retrieve some snails for you as you just go around the site. Unfortunately, I haven't had it happen to me yet, but I've seen lots of encounters shared on the Discord and on Tumblr, so hopefully I'll be able to put up a few photos of that. It seems like the potato quantity goes up as you gain more affection with your pet, but I can't clarify that. It just seems like it does, because my first couple encounters were like 100 potatoes, and now they're between 200 and 300, and I'm expecting that once I finish filling up the first affection milestone, I'll then get even more, but I'll let you know. Overall, the site is in constant improvement. The staff are listening to the users, and updates are coming pretty much every day. There's not a change log, but like a status update thread that you can follow, and you'll get notifications every time something changes. A couple news posts have been made, one for the first couple days and one for the fifth day, dawn of the fifth day, I think it was called. That's pretty much all, yeah. The site has remained an overly positive experience for me and for many other people. It seems that we're not slowing down, we're not dropping out, although my gameplay is slowing down a little bit as I try to get back into the habit of incorporating more than just Dapperwalk in my life. But other than that, yeah, everything seems really nice and pleasant. Although if I were to recommend something, it would be really awesome if Dapperwalk could have a straight up change log, because there are some changes that have been implemented that haven't been explicitly stated. There have been vague comments about balancing, and no one knows what balancing is happening until we find out an item percentage has been dropped by 50% or something. So it would be really cool if there was a change log with explicit details on what is changing. That's all for my short update. Thank you so much for 30 subscribers. I really appreciate all of you being here. I've got like 300 views on one of my videos, which is just insane to me. So thanks so much for being there and for hyping my content. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you around for the next one.